It could be said that everything begins with a vision, a seed of insight, something that we want, hope for, or aspire to comes to us as a vision. We either get a picture or a sense of how it will be, what it will look and feel like to have manifested into reality. What we do with the vision determines our future. Do we embrace it and follow through by paying attention to our intuition and taking inspired, knowing action? Or do we immediately list all of the reasons we can't do it, it can't happen, it's not possible? Most often, we are our own dream killers,
consciously
or unconsciously. We put out the spark before it gets a chance to take hold and flame into life. How do you create a vision that's meaningful, compelling, and rich enough to get you out of
bed each day?
That's what I'm covering today. If you find this podcast useful, please do share it with those who might find it helpful. And I'd be grateful if you could leave a review and subscribe. Every little bit helps the podcast keep going. I'm Heather Masters, and this is the Choosing Happy Podcast. Hello and welcome to the Choosing Happy podcast. At this time of year, many of us are getting ready to set goals and resolutions for the new year. We're looking to change our lives, make commitments. We're getting ready to smash those goals, to hit the gym, to give up alcohol, to do dry January, and many, many more. But how much time do we take to really commit to setting those goals? And how much time do we take to visualizing the results and visualizing how we want our lives to be? Before we set goals, we should really spend time going deep on visualizing what we want for our lives, what we want for our families, for our careers, for our relationships, for our finances. Because only once we have a vision can we really deep into our goals and understand the why behind them. Once we have a why on our goals, we're more motivated, we have meaning. And if we have a vision of them being complete, we know what we're working towards. We already know how we're going to feel. We've already assessed what the impact will be. We already have decided that that's what we want. I do fear that we've all got a bit complacent and familiar with going through the motions of setting goals, especially this time of year. The goal no longer has any emotional pull. We've decided even before we begin that we'll fail and give in. It's absolutely fine to fail on the way to your goal, as long as you're willing to learn from it and get up and continue. High performers and highly successful people really get detailed on their visions. Visions are just so important. Create visions of how they want their lives to be in all areas of their life. A collective vision can have immense power and can create a collective shift in the world and in humanity. For instance, a great leader who shares a vision that others commit to can bring about massive change. For example, Martin Luther King or Nelson Mandela. All manifesting begins with a vision. A vision is the why for most of us, the meaning behind those miraculous things that we do. When we go beyond the boundaries of our comfort zone, it's because we have a vision that we can. Entrepreneurs and business people hold visions of how they want their businesses to grow, of what they can achieve and what they can create. And they use those visions to empower and encourage and inspire staff to follow. Vision is the why for extraordinary people who continue against the odds because they've already seen it done. They've seen it complete. They know they can do it irrespective of all of the opposition. Vision is intrinsically tied to identity. If you have a vision of being a fit person, you live into that. If you have a vision of being a writer, of feeling what it is to write every day and to have a book published, you'll commit and live into that. Vision trumps everything. How precise are you being with your vision for your life, for your career, for your relationships, for your kids, for your health, for your business? How specific is your vision for your career? What type of area do you want to work in? What do you want to create? What legacy do you want to leave behind? Without a vision, we can get comfortable. We can stay stuck. A vision challenges us to reach for more. What's the vision for your relationship with your spouse? Do you know how you want to feel when you're around them? What's that vision for your kids? What legacy do you want to leave? How would you like them to remember you? How would you like them to grow? What opportunities and perspective on life would you like them to have? What's your vision for your physical health? What's your vision for your mental health? What's your vision for your social life, for your travel, for your experiences? What outcomes do you want? How specific are you getting? Visualizing you can do something, which is achievable, has been proven to increase performance. I watched a National Geographic program recently on vision about a young boy who had a brain tumor and had been given 10 days to live, and the doctors had sent him home to die. He refused to accept this, and he visualized his immune system as a scene out of a Star Wars movie where the good cells were small ships attacking the one large enemy ship, the tumor. Within a week, the tumour had drastically reduced in size, and in about a month it had completely gone. Vision coupled with belief can be powerful. A vision provides us with the bigger picture, the overall goal, where we want to be in our life and in our business. It drives and motivates us. If the vision's clear and achievable, it'll provide clarity, not just for ourselves, but for our businesses, our family, our clients and customers. For a business, getting employees to buy into your vision and for them to clearly understand their part in its achievement is a key to success, and we'll often see them performing beyond expectations. Vision provides a long-term objective for an organisation, but also for the individual and their life. So when you wake up on a rainy, grey day at 4 a.m. and you know you have a long flight and a meeting you don't want to attend, kids are complaining and the dog is ill and the car won't start, and you ask yourself, what am I doing this for? Your vision is the why. It's where your motivation comes from. From the anticipation of how you feel when you've achieved your vision, but also knowing that it has greater meaning than just for yourself. This vision can produce unbending self-belief and determination. It can motivate your everyday. It can be powerful and passionate. For a vision to work for you and with you, a vision needs to be aligned with who you are, with your authentic self, for it to be truly impactful. Are your values, beliefs, and what you stand for congruent to your vision for your business and for your life? If not, then you will find the achievement of your vision difficult and may struggle to make it work. So how do you come up with a vision? There are a number of ways to generate a vision. There's the what do I want process, where you enlist the help of a friend or a coach
who asks you what you want.
You write your immediate response down. They ask again, what do you want? And they ask again and again until you can't come up with any more answers. The idea is to keep going even when you're struggling for ideas, because often those last few things that come up are the core to what you really want in your vision. They come from your unconscious, from the deepest part of you. Then you go through the list and filter out what's important to you in your picture of success and achievement.
Another method is
to begin with the end in mind, as Steve Covey tells us in his book, The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. Think of your own eulogy. What would you have liked to have achieved for your business and for your life and for the people around you and for the relationships? What are the key things you want to be remembered for? What difference did you make? What impact? What meaning did you bring to the world? How many people did you help? Another method is to ask yourself, what would you do or achieve if you couldn't fail? If you had one wish, what would that be? If there was only one thing you could do with your life, what would you do? What is the thing you would continue to do if money didn't matter? Once you've a strong idea for your vision, then you're ready for the next step. The next step is to write your vision down. Write it for now, the near and far. So write it for this moment in time, maybe the next month, then take it 6 months out, and then take it a year out, and maybe 3 to 5 years. And use all of your senses to describe your visions. Make it vivid and as real as possible. Write it in the present tense as if you've already achieved it. And again, make it very specific. Think about all angles, whether you're doing the vision for your career, what will your career mean to you? If you're doing it for a relationship, how will your relationship be? How will you be interacting? What will you be expecting? What will they be expecting? Keep it positive and keep it personal. This is yours. Describe the colours, the sounds, the smells, the tastes, how you feel, what you'll be doing, and how will you know you've achieved your vision? Make it real, make it compelling, make it tangible, and make it yours. And then test your vision. Is it realistic and achievable? Only you know if this is true. Often what others see as unrealistic, we have it within us to achieve. So for example, the 3-minute mile. It was said to be physically impossible for a human to run a 3-minute mile. But once it was done, many people followed. For your business vision and for your life vision, check that your goals and your vision match your business reality. So for instance, if you're dreaming of starting a spa, who are the customers that you're going to serve? And are those the customers you're serving now? What are the problems you're solving for them? Do you have experience in solving that now? What industry are you in? Are you in that industry now? These aren't barriers to your vision. It's identifying the steps that will be needed in order to achieve it. What are the barriers to entry? What are the benefits you bring? What are your unique selling points, your differentiator, your gifts, your talents? How will you sell? How much will customers pay? How much will it cost to produce your product or service? Do you even know how you will achieve it? And right at this moment, it probably doesn't matter for your long-term vision that you have these answers. But it will help in terms of finding out the first steps you'll need to take in moving towards your vision. And identify the quick wins and the low-hanging fruit. What are the things you can do today to start moving in that direction? And are you willing to make this vision a reality? Are you willing to put your social life to one side if it's needed? Are you willing to change your lifestyle if required? And what are your motivators? When you look at that vision, what is the motivation behind achieving it? Is it a vision that's serving, a service greater than you? Or is it something that is purely for you and is self-motivated? Are you flexible? Can you ride the waves of change, especially at the moment? Can you be resilient? Can you overcome all of the obstacles that may come your way, especially in the chaos we're living through, in the extraordinary times? Can you keep your eye on the goal? Are you contributing to a new tomorrow, to a greater purpose? Or are you contributing to your family, to your friends, to yourself? Are you creating a legacy for your children? Identify all of this. Be honest with yourself. From your vision, you can derive your strategy and goals for your business and your life. The vision is the main deal. It's the driver. It's your why. It's the overarching reason for your passion, your purpose, your meaning in life and business, and often for your business's existence. The strategy is the overall plan on how you'll achieve your vision. It's dynamic and can be revisited, should be revisited. It's a living document. Everything is changing. Your vision may be way out in the future, and all you need to know to begin are the first few steps. The goals are the milestones within the plan. It's what you need to do. So what are the first couple of goals that you could achieve that move you toward your greater vision? They may even be small goals, just to get you started, to begin the momentum. To keep the vision fresh and alive, once you've written it out, keep it close. Read it every morning. Visualize it every morning. Breathe life into it. Experience it every morning. Keep it front of mind so that it inspires you. It keeps you going through all of the obstacles and the challenges ahead. There's so much more I could go into on vision and on how to create it. But for now, I hope this has really given you a taste of how important a vision is, especially in the times that we're facing. To be able to create a vision of a way forward for yourself and your family in these extraordinary times. Thank you so much for listening. If you found this episode valuable, I'd be grateful if you could share it, if you could subscribe, and even if you could write a review. Every little helps me continue with this podcast. I wish you all the best, and I look forward to seeing you on the next episode of the Choosing Happy podcast.